Why don't we switch gears again to one of I was shown this and I had no fucking clue what was happening. And it regards me, so I'm even less understanding of what's going on. All right, so you start out with this image, the memes. Go Vsauce. This is me. Mm-hmm. States the fact that Empire Strikes Back was received as poorly as The Last Jedi when it came out. Like,
no, it wasn't.
That's not true. Anyway, some dude that watched all of Maul's 3-hour rant videos. Did the past really happen?
What?
So it's just like, at first you're just like, what?
I think I've seen this meme.
Yeah, it's like the complete opposite. The Empire Strikes Back was like a
famously adored. Yeah, and it was subversive.
Like, people were lining up around blocks to see it.
Mm-hmm. Which is not what happened with TLJ.
No, absolutely not.
So part of it, though, is that, like, I don't think I've really ever talked about that in any of my videos. Like, Empire was received better. Like, I don't use that as a reason for anything. So I was just like, okay, this is weird. And then it says, in a few years, it'll be much more appreciated. That's the post. Referring, of course, to Last Jedi. It's like, okay. What does this have to do with me? And then you see some of the comments here, and I was just like, hey. Everyone I know saw ESP when it came out, loved it. Also, Empire wasn't poorly received. No one can back this up. Any article statistics, all you see are lies literally going around the cinema. And was it really? I wasn't alive in the 80s, so I wouldn't know. But it's considered by fans and critics alike to be the best of the OT, and for the most part, all the Star Wars movies, and set the bar for sequels to come. It's obviously not impossible, but it's definitely a bit hard to believe. Is there a source? Like, genuinely asking out of curiosity, I'm not trying to hate. And then the last one, which is just my favorite. What does Maul's videos have to do with ESP's reception? I genuinely don't know.
That's great.
I'm glad to see some sensical comments here before the madness inevitably ensues.
I was going to say, yeah, these ones actually are positively upvoted. So it's like, oh, break the conditioning a little bit. But even I was like, I'm all for, like, you can hate my stuff. It's totally fine. But I was literally just like, what does this have to do with me? I don't even talk about this. What do you mean?
Well, I've got something here from the Wikipedia page, which, you know, take that as you will. But it says, upon its initial release, The Empire Strikes Back received mixed reviews compared to the positive reception of Star Wars. So, like, I don't know if there's a comparison to Star Wars there.
I think we'd all agree it would have been more controversial than Star Wars. Because a couple of choices they make that are a little bit... When we were talking about this, I guess, I don't know, something like 6 hours ago. But the choice to have the hero lose... and lose his arm, and another hero get frozen in carbonite, and a cliffhanger. These are all, like, not the wisest decisions for a broad appeal, but, like, the experiment paid off, if you will. Like, it was... Everybody was fascinated by this as an ending. Loved talking about the controversy of the choices, and then everyone was lining up to see how this trilogy closed out. Like, it's not...
Yeah, generally it wouldn't be a good idea, but it was such a huge surprise. I do believe it was a huge hit.
So, it just feels weird, because, like, you know, if we fast-forwarded, like, fucking 50 years or whatever, and TLJ is considered a masterpiece, I would be kind of baffled. I'd be like, what happened?
I don't think it's going to change.
That's a good movie now. More people enjoy it.
In exhaustive detail, like, the conversation's been had, and the consensus seems to be that it's not good.
Yeah. So anyway, what else we got here?
Yeah.
Funny stories. Well, we got the recent videos. This is the guy I pissed off. This is the first of many threads. I don't know if you know this about me, Chud. I don't remember if I've talked to you about it, but people hate how long I am. It's a big thing.
Yes, the long man. Yes, I've familiar with this. I actually saw a tweet about you on Twitter, and, you know, I was like, okay.
Yeah, and
that's what I found out about your video, and I ended up watching it because of that. So
it's kind of unreal because, like, You might start seeing these everywhere, and at first, I wouldn't even blame you if you thought this was just agreeable. Like, seeing this, especially in the form of Twitter, just being like, what the fuck? Someone made a video that long? It's like, yeah. And you're like, oh yeah, that's an easy like, what a strange person. Like, none of these viral posts, they all with pride announced that they would never watch it. It's just like, I don't know, this is a bit weird. It's always that way.
Don't talk about it! Don't say it's low-effort content!
I'm not actually subscribed to Mauler on YouTube, or I don't follow him on Twitter. I just, like, follow Movie Bob, and then he'll tell me when Mauler releases a video.
We start out with this, okay? So you go, I really hate this style of review where the review is longer than the film. So, I mean, we've talked about it so many times, but, like, who the fuck cares? If you don't want
to
watch
the
review...
This guy seems to be quite bothered by it.
Oh, yeah, well, I guess my point more so is just... if it upsets you, you don't have to watch it. It's the greatest fucking thing. It's like this, yeah. You need to do a whole click before you actually engage with that sort of thing.
I can get some likes on Twitter.com though with minimal effort.
True.
Well, you know what kind of blows my mind about this criticism of you? It's like, don't you have entire like classes dedicated to understanding like one chapter of one book? Like, how many courses can you take on Shakespeare, right? But you're not allowed to do a deep analysis of one movie.
I mean, well, so that's when the truth would come out, because then they would be like, well, it's not that you can't do it long, it's that Mueller makes shallow points. Yeah. Like, aha! So why didn't you make that like tweet? Ones? I hate how he makes shallow points instead of, I hate that it's
but
just
how would
long.
They know you make shallow points, because they claim to not watch your content?
That's the big thing. People would be like, wait, what points do you think were shallow? And then they're like, all of them? I don't know, I didn't see it. It's
like, can I have examples, please?
That would be
because
difficult.
Just like 6 hours worth of
because
shallow
just,
points.
Just assume when it's X amount of time, it's like, oh, you have to ramble. Just going to be redundant all over the place. There's no way for it to work. It's like, okay, how do you know that?
By the way, we had a big old, as you were aware of some of it, Chud, we had this big old thing of like, we kind of hate Twitch for the culture of just playing YouTube videos and not doing anything with it. Only some of you, select people, all right, not all, hashtag,
yeah,
but
not all Twitch
is, you know, there's that was pretty bad, but I will happily say this is worse, where you just literally make threads to target and annoy people based on nothing other than the thumbnail. This is not a particular... It's him being all upset. This is like a still from the movie with a bit of editing, you know? He's like, this is worse, I'd say, where you're saying the thing is actively terrible, but you have no idea what's even in it. I mean, like a step below. Or is it? What's ethically worse? Stealing someone's work and making money off it? Or telling everybody a thing is terrible without having watched it because you hate them?
Ooh, probably the latter is better. I'd say the former.
Being wrong
is worse.
About it. The reality is that the reviews like this aren't long due to any creative choice. It's done to play. I don't think that's how the YouTube's algorithm works.
Oh, we'll get to that. I was just curious how this all ranks. All we've learned is that YouTube is clearly ethically superior to Twitter and Twitch. You know, that's just true.
True.
But yeah, if we go down, it does say, to those asking for further clarification, length isn't necessarily bad. But why the fuck did you say it is?
Exactly.
Yep.
Oh my god. But at a certain point, you make redundant points that repeat themselves. Which is funny, by the way. I do definitely repeat myself in the video, but there is a purpose behind it. I bring up points chronologically, and then I collect them all up at the end to categorize them. And there's usually about 5 hours between those two events, so I figured that it's good to remind people, but...
He remembered. That's how closely he paid attention.
It's also saying you make redundant points that repeat themselves is redundant.
Nice.
That's the kind of shit you catch in editing.
If you want an in-depth review, do it in 30 to 70 minutes. There you go, everyone.
Why?
No more!
Why?
No,
that's how long it is. That, you can go 30 to 70 minutes, and then after that, you will just repeat yourself.
Yeah, just trust
30
me.
30 to 70 minutes.
I don't even
You
like,
can't make a prescription for this. This is personal taste. This
exactly.
Personal
I don't even...
What would they say if you just take a video and just chop it up into these amount of times? Like, parts? 30 to 70 minutes.
They would still screenshot the playlist and treat it the same way.
Yeah, you got shit for that as well, didn't you? So you can't win.
They used to do it with the playlist, yeah, but releasing single videos. I think they prefer it when it's in a single video because they get to
I met all your criteria, though. I met all your criteria. Why is that a problem now? The only criteria is it's too long. Here, have multiple parts.
Because the criteria changes whenever he needs it to change. Like, what? His first update tweet was to change...
Wait, Thunder said this is a Polygon writer, by the way.
Oh, I hope they totally work for CBR.
You. Oh, I absolutely believe he works for the CBR. CBR has got some of the dumbest fucking people working for it ever.
Well, because I was blocked from this thread, and somebody told me that this is the person that's been fighting with, like, Eric July calling out his, like, Ripaverse and stuff.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Eric's been fighting with him.
Well,
Ripaverse.
he goes on to say... The reality is that reviews like this aren't long due to any creative choice. It's done to play YouTube's algorithm. Now, I think it might be worth, because Tud doesn't spend as much time with that little Cassius, he might be considered less biased. What would you say, with your familiarity, is the best thing to do with YouTube's algorithm right now?
In terms of like algorithmically putting your videos in front of people, my understanding is that longer videos don't necessarily play to that. I think longer videos are better for ad revenue because the more ads you get people to see within a video, the better it is. That's my understanding anyway. I've got an editor that does all the YouTube stuff, but that's my guess.
I would think regularity. You'd want...
Yeah. Oh, yeah, regularity, yes, yeah. Regular 30-minute videos would probably be optimum, sure. Probably something like
that. I think that's the meta we're currently in, though a lot of people are suggesting it. It might be true. The shorts might be the new meta, for all I know.
Oh, yeah, shorts go around.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Easy. Yeah, yeah.
Hooray!
I know, right? It's been YouTube into TikTok, I guess.
Five-hour videos, like every few months or whatever, that's not helping you in the algorithm in terms of presenting videos to people. No, that's
probably the worst thing you could do.
Nope.
Well, I said it back when we did other streams today or whatever. I've had several YouTubers come to me and be like, "Why are you shooting yourself in the foot with this?" When it was recommended to me to release this in separate parts, maybe even six across 1 per 2 weeks, that sort of thing. It would be much better for my channel, but I don't want to.
That's what you used to do.
The amount of the people, clearly.
Well, it's just there's a lot of reasons why I don't want to, but part of them, and this is the problem, because everyone's so fucking cynical and content brain that when I say it is a creative choice, most people will be like, "Yeah, sure." I'm just like, okay, I don't know how else I could prove it than other than doing it. Like, what else do you want from me?
I just think, based on our interactions, you don't strike me as someone who is very algorithm content brained. Like, I don't know. I will back you up on that. Okay, you have my seal of approval.
Yay! Well,
and my sword.
Oh, sweet. Sword as well. Nice.
Can have my schleems.
But the level of big brain that genuinely annoyed me here, just to establish, like, you're not doing this for creative reasons. Like, oh. Okay, I guess you saw that.
Hope you say so.
Like, this guy is the arbiter of that, I suppose. fine. Like, there's the Shakespearean essays contain a shorter word count than this review. What the fuck does that have to do with anything?
I was going to say, what the fuck does that matter?
Yeah. So is that an essay about Shakespeare, or is the essay itself Shakespearean?
Sounds like Shakespeare's a fucking bum who's lazy.
Shakespeare's a cuck, that's all I've learned.
Legitimately, that's
like William Shakespeare.
It needs a therefore. If you're longer than Shakespeare, it's just bad.
Yes.
I mean, don't you know? If you're longer than Shakespeare, it's bad. Shakespeare's that's why he's so famous. He knew exactly when to stop. Going further than that is too far.
And then you go, and they, like referring to those essays, often analyze multiple means through which you can interpret and perform the text, as though he knows I don't do that. But I do that. A lot about how you can interpret what the... To be fair, like, I think when I first finished Doctor Strange, I wasn't sure exactly what theme they were going for in that film. But it's just, you know, once you read through it a couple times, then what I guess what I mean by that is trying to piece together certain events and what characters are up to. It's like, oh, I guess I can see what kind of point they may be going for. But funnily enough, with how this works, and I'm sure this guy would agree, I don't even know if Michael Waldron intended for what I dug out of it in terms of what I thought the overall theme was. I have no idea. Good old death of the author, which is probably I'm not going to make that joke. Anyway, all of this reminds me of that scene from Dead Poets Society where they mock the idea that you can objectively judge a poem's quality on a graph. I don't use the word objective in that review at all. Or assessment, whatever you want to call it. The entire video.
This person doesn't like you, and they know about these criticisms of you, right?
Yeah, this is just like the...
Yep.
But you do have a bunch of pie charts in your video and bar graphs.
I did.
So get fucked.
I was just like, okay. And by the way, this came out, I think it was a couple of hours after the premiere finished. This guy was waiting for me.
Maybe he likes you.
What a fucking loser. Like, they literally don't like you. And rather than honestly state it, they're like trying to act like, oh, I'm just doing a criticism, guys. Like,
well, you see, I'm an artist, and I recognize that this is a faulty work, for it must relate to a 30 to 70 minute runtime. If not, it is a failure.
Hundreds of years ago.
Ish posh.
There was one other post on this. This got 10 likes, by the way. I was at the time. I don't know what it's up to at this point, but someone replied to his initial thing and said, "Mueller is the worst. You could fully review it in 10 minutes. People who watch these videos are scamming themselves."
When I was about four hours in, I felt scammed, but, you know, I just figure, you know, I've already invested my time. I might as well go all the way.
I legit have no fucking clue what he's... What are they being scammed out of? Time.
Yeah.
Plushy money, man, at the very end.
Those plushies are a scam. They're front
I think, yeah. I feel like the culture...
free to watch.
I feel like the culture of like consuming YouTube videos is such now that people will kind of put it on whilst they're playing a game or doing something else or something. Absolutely. So, you know, I don't think there's really a scam happening there. That's crazy.
Yeah. I don't know what I promised to be in the video that I lied about. You know, it's such a bizarre concept. Like,
I know. Yeah, the time code was on the thumbnail, like,
as you pointed out. Like,
there's no lie.
They click the video and they're like, "Wow, this is going on a long time." And they're like, "It's still going." Like an hour passed, and like, holy fuck, we're barely. They can't leave. They're just stuck there. And like, I just like, oh, piss, fucking hell, goddamn, I'm thirsty too.
Okay,
I should have brought provisions.
At random, I picked one of this person's articles on CBR, and the one I happened to pick was who would win in a battle between Superman and Thor? Correct me if I'm wrong, but such a thing has never occurred, right? Superman and Thor have never. They are from different. Universes entirely.
Maybe it happened in JLA Avengers, but I don't think we got like definitive answers on that.
Suffice
one.
Nice to say, they wrote an 829 word article about this thing that never happened.
Wow, so they have broken the rules. They have broken the rules.
Yep.
Can't have that. Oof. Gotta take his own man.
If I may paraphrase like a response to one of these tweets that I read, I thought it's really succinct. So let's just say you have a bucket of milk, you know, you've just milked your cow as you do, and you got it. It's just like, oh no, I tripped and spilt the milk. That is an action that took 2 seconds. 2 seconds to spill a bucket of milk. Now, if you were to describe the action of spilling the bucket of milk in detail, you know, if you go with every step, like all the physics involved, or the, you know, the leg coming into contact with the bucket, and then it flipped upside down and the liquid went out and it spilled, seeping into the floor. That would take, you know, maybe 20, 30 seconds to fully describe, maybe even going into the minutes, depending on how absurdly details you want to get with that. And then it would take many more minutes to mop up the mess that was the spilt milk. So I think that kind of describes why these videos take so long, because it takes much longer to describe the act of spilling the milk than it does to spill the milk. And it takes a fuck ton more time to clean up the mess than it does to make the mess in the first place.
I mean,
no, I'll get a job.
Yeah, to make it as simple as possible, if Clark Kent just pulls out a fucking pistol and shoots Lois Lane in the head, and it takes 2 seconds, don't you think I'm going to talk about that for a little more than 2 seconds?
You have 2 seconds to talk about it. But go.
That was bad.
I think there is an even, that is a very simple way. I just want to say the milk thing, there's an even easier one. It takes 2 seconds to knock over a glass of wine and 20 minutes to clean it up. Okay, that's the simplest way of putting it.
Yeah,
I like the milk one, though, because it's funny. Gravity, no, it's funny, I like the milk one.
Gravity is the soul of wit.
Sure.
Yeah, William Shakespeare said that, and he's the gold standard.
Take a spear, that's what it was. He shook spears or whatever, he's all about that.
Take your spear as Shakespeare. Yep.
It's generally frowned upon, but
like to shake my spear around.
Well, anyway.
Anyway, listen. Sorry, this pause is a great. I've got to shoot. So this is a great moment for me to step out.
Well, no problem. Thank you for jumping in. I hope this was fun.
You've got to shoot.
I did
have
fun.
Shoot. I was just about to say. You have to
listen.
Shoot. Who?
I want to come on and argue with you racists about why I don't know the next black fucking whatever is good. So maybe we should do that sometime. I don't know.
Oh, that'll be Wakanda forever.
Oh god, I'm probably won't like, to be honest, I probably won't like that. I mean, yeah, let's not go into too much detail now,
because they're black. Wow.
Come
debate us on Endgame.
That, people,
come talk to Fringy about why you like Endgame.
Oh my god, but like, I'll have to be autistic and watch it and be like, oh no, what about this fucking shot and shit? No thank you.
Yeah,
maybe we'll talk about it anyway. Right. Listen, pleasure everyone, nice to see you all. I'll catch you all later. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, catch you around, dude.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Right, listen,
later, alligator.
It takes me 2 seconds to kill someone but upwards of 30 minutes to dispose of the body.
I found that too. Yeah,
it takes me 10 minutes to describe the murder to the police.
So I think that was a good little selection, but I have a couple more. Alright.
Oh my goodness, Chris.
For you guys. I don't even know where this is from. I just saw people posting on the Discord. I don't know what forum this is what I'm saying. I don't recognize it, but they are words and they have been put together by someone.
Alright.
Exciting.
So this is how it starts.
Show me the words.
Maul?
Jeez.
You mean that stupid nitpicking moron who makes hour-long videos to tediously nitpick movies? Get in with that nonsense.
Not movies.
He's not a critic. He doesn't know how to criticism works. He's basically CinemaSins, except he's not a gimmick, and he thinks asking questions about the movies he's talking about is criticism. It's not, by the way. And you're stupid for watching these stupid YouTubers who don't know what they're talking about. It's like, all right, good start. I'm feeling the vibes. All right,
I like it.
Also, Captain Marvel's personality is far more interesting than everyone else's.
Everyone else.
So,
what?
Wow, holy fuck.
What?
To be honest with you.
What?
No other explanation.
Oh my god.
This is such a your stock is plummeting.
Sell.
I'll go great so far.
No.
I'm buying the dip. I don't know about you guys.
Spider-Man is an idiot that learns to be more responsible, and that's it.
Oh.
All right.
Don't make me stand up.
That's an arc. That's something.
Learning
to be more
responsible. That's it, man. Come on.
That's shit.
Star-Lord is an endearing goofball and not much else. All right.
What is Captain Marvel?
I know what you did.
Oh, we get that. Iron Man is better than the other two you just mentioned, but even so, he's a narcissistic, snarky playboy who's only a scientific genius. Who's only a scientific genius only. Okay? And even then, he's not the smartest.
But you just described to other three...
I don't even know what he's not the smartest man in the MCU. It's like, okay.
What an idiot. He's not even the smartest fucking dumbass.
Meanwhile,
he's only a scientific genius only after describing three other fucking personality traits.
Yeah, the smartest vendor is Chair Devil.
I remember Chair Devil. Times.
Chair Devil.
So yeah, his assessment, good old Captain Marvel, is he's cocky, confident, measured, endearing, stoic, and militant. You'd know this if you actually watched the movie, but you clearly didn't. Clearly you're repeating what others are saying because you can't think for yourself. By the way, these YouTubers you're watching aren't actual critics. They're morons who talk about how they feel rather than people who can actually analyze and criticize movies and video games.
Oh, that's like the opposite of what you usually get.
This is what I mean. It's like,
wow.
Their criticism of people like us so that we talk too much about our feelings.
Yeah, you're a touchy-feely kind of guy, Muller.
I'm almost like, why?
Feel you touchy.
Well, I feel like that person is lying to me.
Well, they go on. They have more to say.
Oh, nice.
Oh, there's more.
There is more. There's a whole other part. If Spider-Man has learned from his actions, then explain No Way Home. What happened in any way home?
I agree. Absolutely.
In any
way,
like a weeb word.
Absolutely.
I'm not wrong about Captain Marvel. You are wrong. Furthermore, you don't form your own opinions when criticizing a movie. You see if the movie is clear, concise, and consistent with its objectives. Mauler does no such thing.
Are you shitting me right now?
Definitely consistent with its objectives.
I just want to know whose opinion you still.
Man, are we certain this isn't a troll?
I don't know what this is. It's such a bizarre thing. You know, like when some trolls that you can sort of track because of how they're crafted in a very particular way, but like this is such a mess that it feels a little bit more like a ramble and thus maybe real.
I think it is real because the idea that the idea that you should judge a movie based on its own objectives, like not every movie has to is trying to make sense. You know, it has different objectives. That's a real thing.
People
think.
Definitely say that.
Like Tenet.
Also, welcome back, CJ.
No thoughts, just vibes.
Hello again.
How long have we got? We got another 4 hours, I think.
Something like that.
God.
Something like that.
No.
3.5.
Right?
No, the long must never cease.
A little less, right?
About 2.5.
Our long
not
trek
according to me. We
will
got,
go on forever.
We had to do 6 hours and 5 minutes to finish it off, and we are up to 2 hours and 46
oh,
minutes.
Oh, right, we had the breaks. We had the breaks in between. Okay.
I'm sorry about that, but that's just how it works. Remember when Sitch was calling us out about how we end up doing less, and it's like, no, we end up doing more.
Yeah, what a loser.
Long more. Anyway.
More
so you got, firstly... Oh wait, yeah, that's it. Firstly, he doesn't quantify the movies he criticizes. He assumes that merely asking questions is enough to criticize and analyze a movie when he should point out what the movie's intentions are. I mean,
very true.
Isn't that basically in when I'm describing the events and what characters are trying to do and their goals? And then the theme. Surely that covers it. What else is there?
Yeah, I don't understand the what is the problem here? Oh wait, they don't watch your videos, I'm sorry.
Oh, God damn it. He repeatedly nitpicks most scenes in every movie without highlighting what went wrong. Really? I feel like I...
Come on. Fascinating. How did you reach this conclusion?
I just did. The guy just asked questions only, as though he doesn't know what he's talking about. I ask questions as though I don't know what I'm talking about, right?
Well, I'm seeing a person who doesn't know what they're talking about, and they're in text form.
Hey, they're asking a lot of... Well, yeah, they are asking some questions.
I'm not in text form.
This post really has "so I started typing" energy.
Yeah.
So anyway, I started blasting.
I started telling.
As though he doesn't know that the movie's intentions are, and with all that in his mind, how good at movie criticism when... Jesus Christ. How he is he good at movie criticism when he's just asking questions, some of which are either unnecessary or stupid. You say a lot for a little. Like, you just, you know, you just wanted to say sometimes his answers to my questions. Which is fine. What makes me better than him? Why would you even... Okay.
Well, I don't know. What? If it isn't already obvious.
Dude, look at the brackets. Not that I care about comparing myself to him. Yes, we hit another one.
I care. Yeah.
Like, we had about Star Wars, but
we had a theme today, and we have nailed the people who definitely do not care about the thing they chose to tell
very
me about.
Very thematically consistent. That's
very
great.
Nuh-uh.
Is that I know that movies are made for a reason. He doesn't know that.
Oh my God.
Sacred knowledge about that has been withheld from you.
He also only cares about the popular opinion of the movies he talks about. Oh.
Mm. Oh man.
No.
I wish. It would be much more stressful.
Remember the Snyder Cut?
I feel like the Snyder Cut was an example. I'm haunted to this day.
You
so
said Justice League was better.
Yeah, that's like one of the most unpopular opinions possible. Like, like, we got in trouble for that over at EFAP, but we're still alive.
We were the
only
people saying it.
Yeah, well, I there's probably like a couple here
Chas
and there.
I think Sweden might have been saying it.
Maybe.
I've seen some like different people on Twitter and different these comments. I think somebody in Chud Logic's chat was saying that the Snyder Cut video is really good, so I'm assuming they agree, but it's a very rare position. Mostly, like 99% of people like the Snyder Cut is easily better. So saying that, I imagine EFAP chat is mostly on our side with that one. There's probably...
The amount of times I have to tell my friends why I think things are shit. It's like, hey, did you watch this? Yeah, it was bad. It's like, oh.
It was pretty easy to sort of assess. Joss Whedon added a bunch of character scenes for Batman and Wonder Woman. And I've seen people fight in Snyder circles over whether or not the line from Batman, "just save one," is a good line or not. And to me, I'm just like, it's obviously good. Like, the encouraging the Flash, who's timid and scared, to, like, get him started to save one person, then he starts saving all of them. It's like, how is that not a good line?
Yeah, as if he's just going to save one, and Flash is going to come back, and he says, all right.
Now what?
It is funny to kind of put out of context, though, considering how we went from saving zero in Man of Steel and BVS to saving one in Justice League. That is an improvement. We are getting to hero. There we go. Save one. You got to start small. You can improve. Yeah. Self-improvement.
He doesn't have any substance. Damn. He, like all the other stupid movie YouTubers, just talks about how he feels about the movie instead of highlighting the movie's objectives, criticizing the movies in regards to their objectives. He only asks questions, and he comes off as someone who didn't watch the movie he's talking about.
Oh my God.
That's what I felt. I think it was weird when I got to about the two-hour mark, and I was thinking, has he even seen this film?
Yeah. I mean, I think if you were to
this post
pop
was
up the video
about CinemaSins, and then they just changed the name to Mola.
I mean, even CinemaSins, like, I don't know, give him a little bit more credit. This person's very angry at things. I think if you cut up the video I made, you might be able to string together most of the movie in the form of audio clips. A lot of it's in there, not all of it, but a lot of it. I probably watched it while editing, at least, right?
Maybe.
No.
So, this one's,
You don't edit your videos, Mola. Everyone knows that. That's why they're so long.
Oh, man.
I don't know how I managed to do it.
You can't fool us.
Yeah, I don't even know where this is from again, but, it was Reddit, at least. But Mola literally hates anything that's popular with casual audiences. Laugh my ass off. That's a really weird thing for me to read, but I have downright normie takes on a lot of popular stuff, so I'm just like, yeah, sure. So it says, you know, Infinity War, Civil War, Joker. And it's like, he likes Joker and hates Black Widow. Yeah, I see him. Fuck him.
What? That is a lot.
Abandoned the original point and have moved on to a different one.
I remember reading it just be like, what does that mean? It's like, you fit a profile. He also likes Aliens, a movie with a female protagonist, if that's what you're implying, and not everything's about gender. And they got, just say, I also like Aliens. No one spends this time defending random YouTubers.
Oh my god.
What? Yeah, but you're the one who attacked
no,
in the
first
place.
No, it's not random YouTubers, it's specifically Mahler. Very specifically Mahler.
But
yeah.
Criticize him for liking Joker YouTuber. Over Black Widow, and I thought you were making him out to be a sexist. I said, that wasn't the criticism. I cared enough to comment originally, but we're a bit later now, and I don't care enough anymore.
They always do it. They always fucking do it. They always run.
I concede victory.
But like, this wasn't even a fatigue thing. This was literally just trying to find out what they think, and then they were like, enough! Mm-hmm. I'm leaving. Like, oh.
I don't think I Retreat. Only spew.
I shouldn't have to put up with this. Ridiculous. Alrighty. This one was nuts. This was from a YouTube comment section, and I think the context is it was soon after some discussion where we talked about the Flash's big payoff in Snyder Cut, but it was also just after, I think it was the first half of the multiverse discussion. So someone, I think in the EFAP audience, I'm not actually sure if this is who they are exactly, but they were very upset with both those takes, to the point where I think this is one of them, your critiques are poor sort of moments, where they're just like, I've had enough.
No.
Last straw has been snapped. It is time to tell EFAP where they are incorrect.
Duke Nukem, no.
Do you want to take this one, Rags? Why not?
Yeah, sure. Why not? It's probably
do it, Rags.
You are all the same. Time and time again, you all agree. So there's no point in spending 8 or 9 hours discussing a movie you don't even like. For fuck's sake, you cowards wasted an hour avoiding Shang-Chi. Probably wasted an hour avoiding Shang-Chi.
Correct me if I'm wrong, because I really don't remember. Didn't we do a whole breakdown of Shang-Chi?
We did. I remember
it was a lot longer than an hour because Shad was there for it all, right?
Yeah, free. Are you talking about the hour in the stream before you actually start talking about it?
Oh, is that what he's saying?
Maybe we have long intros, but then we spent the like 5 hours talking about it or whatever.
I have to assume that's what he's talking about.
Yeah.
What does he mean avoiding? We just talk. We talk about the other thing. That was sad.
Talking is cringe.
I think we're all of the opinion like Shang-Chi isn't as bad as like Thor: Love and Thunder and Black Widow and MOM, but it's not good.
It's still pretty bad from what I hear.
Yeah.
Anyway,
it's inoffensive subjectively, but it's got a huge amount of problems.
All right, so we cowards, you cowards wasted an hour avoiding Shang-Chi. Probably because you didn't want to admit that you just didn't like the film that suspiciously is the third damn movie in a row with a minority lead you hated.
What?
Two films is coincidence, but one after another is a fucking pattern. You also do not understand things like cosmic horror or high concepts.
Ah.
You obsessed over concept. Things like logic. And consistency.
How dare you?
Yeah. The whole fucking point is that it isn't.
It isn't
Jesus.
What, logic? It isn't consistency?
It isn't logic. It isn't logic and consistency.
All right. Yeah.
Jesus fucking Christ. If I locked you motherfuckers in a room and forced you to watch everything in the Nasu-verse.
Probably
you, I don't, yeah, probably. You would, oh, I could tell, yeah, I could believe it. You would be sobbing wrecks by the time I let you out.
Is it really that
the
bad?
The multiverse, or is it that emotional?
Oh,
or like
yeah,
it would,
maybe.
I don't even know. The multiverse is an infinite number of possibilities, not just timelines. That's a sentence. It is a very complex subject that is difficult to fully understand because infinity is just that. Endless. That's actually not true. You cannot count it. That is accurate. You cannot rationalize it. True, it's an irrational number.
There are
you cannot comprehend
infinities.
It. That's the ultimate reason why Kang made Loki kill him. We didn't make Loki kill him, right?
I mean,
we left it up to them to decide.
Yeah, well, that's what he said. I don't fucking know. I have no idea. I get it. Like, because when you're someone like Kang, surely he would just know immediately what Loki or Sylvie would decide. So by him choosing to let them do it as of their free will. He already knew what the result would be, right? Or am I missing? I don't know. Or did he say like he just has no idea what's happening anymore? Because he used to look ahead or something.
He said, "Up to this point, I knew everything, but yeah. Now I've stopped everything. From now on, it's just whatever happens."
So yeah, and so the ultimate reason why Kang made Loki, yeah, he didn't make him kill him, from what I remember.
Yeah, I thought that was the whole point.
Yeah,
that's the ultimate reason why Kang made Loki kill him, because he knew that you cannot control something like this.
No, you can.
Like what?
He was controlling
something like
it.
What? Yeah, he's controlling literally everything in all of the cosmos.
Yeah, the sacred time. Isn't like the whole fucking reason he got bored? Wasn't that like basically it? He was like, I've been doing this for forever, and he wants something else to happen.
I'm pretty sure that the dichotomous choice that he presented was, we can just keep doing this where I'm in control of everything, or we can see what happens.
Yeah, he's like, he's just like, let's just try something else,
he
basically.
He definitely can control something like this.
Yeah, there's no reason. When Sylvie and Loki do all of their crazy adventures to get to him, he orchestrated all of it. That wasn't them breaching the system.
Exactly. Because they proceed to say you have things fall through the cracks all the time, which they did. It's like, yeah, but then they fixed it every time because there's only one timeline. So they fixed it all the time.
Yeah. You're angry at.
And the time heist didn't break what little control they had. The time heist was something they knew was going to happen. It was allowed to happen, it was planned to happen.
Yeah, it was all facilitated.
Only an ignorant idiot who doesn't pay attention would not understand this. They explicitly say that the time heist was allowed.
Everything up to the moment that they're sitting in those chairs was planned by Kang.
Everything.
Which really took away from the show, by the way, but the show took away from the entire MCU, so.
Yeah.
When you get it, like, so wrong, and then you, well, I guess if we assume that when it's in capital letters, that's meant to be yelling or whatnot.
Meant to elicit a sense that he is shouting, yes.
And lots of exclamation marks, but then you just get these things completely wrong. Like, explicitly, you're contradicted.
Yeah. There's something, it's just, you admire the audacity of it all, really.
Well, just calm down, you know?
Yeah, you'll be fine. Yeah, we didn't like Loki.
Facts wrong.
No, that's fine. You'll right, be fine.
Is this like a troll thing? Is this like a meme?
This I would go as far as saying this looks like an angry young person who's just venting.
Yeah, probably.
And it's kind of funny.
Let's see. Even if you did control everything, like the TVA, you will have things fall through the cracks all the time, which they did. That's an odd sentence.
We read ahead, and
oh yeah, we've kind of addressed all of that.
Yeah, the time heist broke what little control they had. You just said they controlled everything all the time.
They maintained one singular timeline. That is not little control. That is absolute control, motherfucker. Mm-hmm.
Kang explicitly says that, like, everything... We've already said it, but Kang explicitly said that everything that happened leading up to the point was planned, so you're just wrong. I guess we want to skip to the next paragraph.
Okay.
This is
also
why I think this is a meme, by the way, this paragraph.
Oh, okay.
Also, unless this channel starts reviewing anime, I will never respond to anything this channel or anything of the channels that associate with EFAP says or does, because there is so much more out there that would make them beg for Disney, and unlike them, I'm smart enough to know that.
Wait, are they saying
no?
Wait, are they saying that anime is so bad we'll think Disney's good?
So it sounds
or,
like.
Damn,
you're
offended by that.
There's so much more out there that would make them beg for Disney. That's kind of what he's saying.
I think
but
so. Yeah.
He sounds like he wants you to review anime.
Oh, definitely. That's the impression I'm getting. We have plenty of fans who want us to review anime. Probably not going to happen.
Yeah.
Didn't he just complain because you guys criticized movies with minorities as leads, and now he wants you to? This person is
making
fucking sense.
Did you say
you hated
Shang-Chi? Isn't that? I feel like
we don't hate Shang-Chi.
No, I don't hate Shang-Chi. It's not really... It's inoffensive.
I hate some of the choices they make. And I hate, like, you know, like, Death Dealer dying and that old dude that just gets casually soul-sucked. Like, both of those really annoy me, but, like, you know, it's nowhere near... We're not dealing
with,
you know...
Because he says at the beginning, like, the third damn movie in a row with a minority lead you hated. It's like, I've not heard, like, anywhere near the amount of scathing criticism that for Shang-Chi as a character, as like Captain Marvel or what have you, She-Hulk, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Weird. This whole thing is kind of odd. I mean, well, look at the next bit.
Alright. And no! The Flash cannot fix everything and is not overpowered. It is heavily implied that he has no idea what he can do and isn't sure he can't control it. And I am sick of people pretending that he didn't say that when he fucking did.
I think this is referring to how we said there was nothing to really worry about because he just uses time travel and it just works, you know?
Yeah, there doesn't seem to be any consequences negative whatsoever.
Yep. Like, there's not much tension in the scene because it's just like, it's just a clean win button.
If you remember,
it seems like a really awesome world.
I mean, what's the point of that? It just saves the world.
It's the universe. By the way, it's the same problem we have with the stones. That's why I brought them up in the MOM review. It's just like, well, we got a problem here. Use the stones. And it's like, well, we don't have any. It's like, time heist. Stones. Off you go.
Yeah, easy.
We'll solve it every time. It's the win button. You know, why not? So,
to be fair, that scene was an Oscar's fan favorite moment. So.
Sure it was. I'm sure that was very genuine.
What did that Warner Brothers investigation say again? Snyder Cut Stones, Flash, man.
Funny stuff.
Yeah.
The Snyder Cut Flash scene was like the worst execution of Flash time travel in media, I think.
We need to do a Flashpoint Paradox at some point, meme.
We do.
Oh, in a similar vein, but once again, I'm now lost on exactly where the format for this one was. Could be YouTube, but you got really sad that this hate speech, ripe talking, is viewed at all by anyone. It was a good action movie or film. The whole Marvel Universe is fiction. I don't think the YouTuber knows this fact. Not a documentary. Not supposed to be real life or factual. Anybody that watches the news right now knows what evil and disastrous things are going on. We watch these films and read these comics to escape reality and hope for heroes. I know people that hate any fiction. They are incredibly dry, conversationalist people. I don't know how they get up in the morning.
Holy crap.
That's great.
Sorry. I hope you're okay.
I shouldn't be surprised, but I really am surprised how many people think, oh, that's fiction, so just stop.
Just do whatever you want.
That's a good defense.
It's fiction, so why do you care what we have to say about it?
Yeah.
Man.
It's not real. I can't hurt Captain America's feelings, you know?
Guys, did you know that it's fake? It's not real. We made it all up.
Yeah, man, I'm gonna write a story where I hurt Captain America's feelings, and I'm going to put it on the internet.
Oh,
and they're gonna
no.
Read it.
Don't you... Yeah, that's horrifying.
But it's fine because I don't even care.
Well, that's your opinion.
I'm upset by the very idea.
Never happened.
This is one. This almost made it into the last multimedia we did, but it just slipped by because I think I'd left it somewhere else. But hey,
oh my,
kind of amusing. They got YMS released his Lion King review, and some subreddits were upset with him. They said Adam's turning into Mauler before our eyes. I disagree.
God, that's such a good video.
Wait for it. We're right. Yeah, this is good shit.
Okay.
I disagree. Mueller is shit because he spends a lot of time talking about SJWs and woke nonsense, repeating the same shitty opinions for 8 hours.
Yeah, all the time, Mueller.
Totally what I do. Adam's video is edited, has a clear structure. Also, he doesn't just dissect the movie. He talks about the train wreck that was a production. I don't do any of that, by the way. I only talk about SJWs.
You're a lazy bum.
And then sarcastic, jokey tone. Wow, seems like someone loves SJW and woke nonsense. So someone made a little thing of these were clearly the chapters in my Star Wars review. You got introduction, naturally. Then Leia has been ruined because she's a woman. Of course. How can a girl beat a man in a fight? What the fuck? That was a great like analysis, I think. Contrivance is when women succeed at things. That was. I don't think I need to explain that.
That was my favorite part of your video, by the way. Good job on that.
When black people exist, it makes me angry.
When they exist.
13 minutes on that.
That's great. Then we got Kylo Ren, apex homosexual. That was a controversial one, but I think I convinced a lot of people.
I can outdo it.
I hate Snoke because he's trans Palpatine.
Is it bad that I really want to watch this version of your video?
You get to look at many women in this movie. Is that good or bad? Ah, yes.
Bad. See, very bad.
I answer that question depends on the woman. Just around 2 minutes.
Depends
there.
On the clothing.
Not bad. Yeah. Kathleen Kennedy stole my Halloween. True.
you didn't edit that bit. That goes for 20 minutes.
Bitch. Yeah. First Order destroys planets. Is this woke environmentalism messaging? Of course. And then we get to the outro. I personally thank Ronald Reagan for being an inspiration, as I do in every video. And check out EFAP.
Dr. Strange, tear down this wall.
Check out EFAP. We bully women for having opinions weekly. Yeah, we've been done in this week as well, yeah. And outtakes from a cameo done by my best friend, no bullshit. We've worked together for years.
Everyone's favorite.
Like, no
turtle.
Remarkable Republican? Damn.
This is such a, like, when they go, like, he only talks about the woke nods, that you have a moment of just like, do you even know, like, anything about him? This guy
have
you're talking about.
Ever watched
about,
a
like,
video?
Well, you breathed near Sargon once, so clearly
oh,
that means...
Oh, yeah, that's a bad.
I did. Ooh. Yeah. Mistake. Apparently, some people were saying he was very drunk in our chat earlier. I must have missed it. I already saw he said hello or something, but...
Wait, does he hate watching us like Sish and Adam?
Oh, maybe.
Yeah, he did pop up. I didn't really pay that close attention to it. I'm currently getting drunk, though, so, you know, I will be joining him.
What are some positive, or at least non-toxic YouTube videos about the sequel trilogy or the films individually? I can't type in anything with the movies into the search bar without being bombarded with the likes of Mauler and such.
Oh, the likes of Mauler.
Oh, so clearly you've watched the content to know that it's not, that it's completely toxic, right? That's how you know it's toxic.
I feel bad for you sometimes. You just keep getting relentlessly shit on and just like entirely made up that aren't even
I don't
in your
feel
videos.
Bad. You deserve it.
I'm a bad. I don't even. There's a lot of results when you search for anything in YouTube. Am I really taking up all of it? Like you're scrolling,
all
just like,
it.
Oh, don't you hide channel or whatever? Doesn't that just solve it?